everyone. Welcome again to our IYF Academy online classes. I'm very happy to have this lesson with you again. And you will remember this is our fourth lesson. And as we continue with our lessons like this, I will also be reminding you so that you know where we are. So this is our fourth one. And I want us to review a bit what we did in lesson 3, and then we'll continue with the topic of lesson 4. Lesson 5, this is lesson 5. So let's see what we covered on lesson. So you'll remember we talked about the numbers, and we learned from 0 to 10. So we'll not continue for now until you master, until you understand clearly how to count in French. So what we are going to do today for this lesson, we want to cover about some very important words or vocabularies, kind of, or some, we can call them the personal pronouns that will help us to be making our sentences. Of course, you are learning a language, not just for the sake of learning, but you also have to be able to express yourself in that language. You also have to be able to start conversing with others in that language. So before we get there, let's see, let's review a bit about the numbers. You'll remember that the topic was nombre, and this is how we write nombre in French. And then we have zero. We said this is zero, and then this is un, this is deux, and then we said this is trois, and then this is quatre. So we said this is quatre, and then this is quatre, cinq, cinq, and then this is six, then we have here sept, and then we have huit, then we have neuf, and finally we have dix. So this is the way you are supposed to count in French from 0 to 10. So we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we can, the last time we can revise, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's it. So those are the numbers. And we did this in class 4. Now, let's see what I want us to learn about, in lesson 5. In lesson 5, we'll talk about the personal pronoun. We call them in French pronom personnel. For the pronom personnel, I want you to know this. It is important from the beginning as you are learning French to know the pronom personnel. Why? Because it helps us to start making our sentences. This will help us to know on how we can, by ourselves at home, as we are at home, we are doing this self-learning, how to start making your own sentences. That's why I thought it's very important from the beginning like this to know the personal pronoun. As we agreed that I will be writing the French here and you just write the English in your notebook. So this is the pronoun personnel. Of course, you can just see in English it's just the opposite one. So you have a personal pronoun. Of course, the spelling is not exactly the same, but it's almost the same. So this is French. Pronom personnel. So in this pronom personnel, I want us to cover this. There is what we call here je. There is what we call je, and it's written like that, je. And then we have tu. After tu, we have il, elle. And then we have nous. We say nous. Remember, I talked about the consonant in consonne, the consonant ending the French word most these French words, the most of this last consonant, they don't sound actually. That's why we have nous instead of nous. So don't say nous. Nous doesn't exist in French. You have to say nous. And then we have vous, and don't say vous, please. You have to say vous. And then you have the il and l in plural. Il, it is the same here, the il, and then you have l, e, l, e, s. So same, almost same here, it's just in plural form. So what does this mean in French, in English? So je means I. Tu means you. Il means he. Now you understand the pronom personnel I'm talking on. So je is I, tu is you, il is he, elle is she. Now you can guess. What about nous? Following this order, obviously you will see nous is we. What about vous now? This is you in plural form. And then these two, they mean the pronoun they. Like that. So, je is I, tu is you, il is he, elle, she, nous, we, vous, you, il, elle, the two of them, they sound il, elle the same way, il, il, elle, elle, same thing, even if they have this SS, but they sound il, elle, same thing. And then the two of them, they mean they. So, in French, we pronounce like this, we have je, tu, il, elle, nous, vous, il, elle. You have je, tu, il, elle, nous, vous, il, elle. These are what we call the pronoms personnels. So these are the pronoms personnels. The pronoms personnels. And then after this, there is also something important which you have to know about introduction. In French, we call it présentation. Because after knowing the pronom personnel, now you have to know the présentation. As you can see, the spelling is just the English one, presentation. But because of this accent, now that is French, présentation. So this présentation, it is about how to introduce yourself to people. When you see someone, when you meet someone, of course you have to say, oh, I'm so and so, maybe I come from this place, I'm going to this place, or something like that. Oh, how are you? I'm fine, something like that. This is what I want us to cover for now. Just in some 2-3 minutes, you have to learn on how to introduce yourself. After knowing this pronom personnel, you also have to know how to introduce yourself in some 2-3 minutes. Actually, first of all, of course, you have to say your name. This is a common one which is known by many people. Let's say my name is François. I have to say, je m'appelle François. And please don't confuse. The language you are learning is français, and the name of your teacher is François. So, je m'appelle François. You can, je suis Kenyan, like that. Je suis Kenyan, and I will just give you this because of time, and then we'll continue. Je suis Kenyan, and then you say, j'habite à Nairobi. I will take that just in a general way. J'habite à Nairobi. So you say, je m'appelle. This is obvious. So many people, even in music, even in Congolese music, you hear people, those musicians, they sing, je m'appelle, comment tu t'appelles, je m'appelle, something like, I know you understand what I mean. I'm very sure you understand because there is a Congolese musician who sings like that. So, je m'appelle François. So here you can put your name, je m'appelle Kamau, je m'appelle Aluoch, je m'appelle Musioka, something like that. And je suis Kenyan, and then j'habite à Nairobi. Obviously, even if I haven't given you the meaning, you can guess. So if je m'appelle François means my name is François. What about je suis Kenyan? Because you have K here, so obviously this will be I am a Kenyan. So je suis Kenyan means I am a Kenyan. And then Jabit and Nairobi, obviously you have the place, so it means I stay in Nairobi. So for today, we'll cover those two topics, pronom personnel and presentation. Thank you very much. IYF Online Academy. So please subscribe to our IYF YouTube channel, IYF Kenya TV, and Facebook page. You see us through the name IYF Kenya. So you can like our page, you make some comments there, and you share our videos with other people. So thank you so much, and see you next lesson. Thank you.